Welcome to the University of Alabama in Birmingham. You are here in my laboratory at the O'Neill Comprehensive Cancer Center. My laboratory studies malignant brain tumors, and today we would like to present you the results of our study that is to be published imminently. So the problem with brain tumors is that unfortunately they are very poor prognosis. And in our case, we study glioblastoma, the most malignant brain tumor in adults. The patients, despite surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation, have an outcome of about 15 months. And the reason for this is that the tumors recur after they have been treated, and then these tumor cells are able to be resistant to the treatment, and this leads to the patient demise. So the goal of our study was to examine how a glioblastoma becomes resistant to radiation therapy. And this work was done by Dr. Osuka, who is joining me now, and he will explain a little bit more about the details of the study.
Thank you for introducing me. I'd like to introduce our findings. So please look at our slides.
Glioblastoma is composed of heterogeneous tumor cell populations, including those with stem cell properties, termed glioma stem cells. GSCs have strong radioresistance and are believed to initiate a recurrent tumor formation. However, it is unclear how glioma stem cells adapt to escape the toxicity of repeated irradiation used in clinical practice. To analyze it, we developed a model of radioresistant glioma stem cells. In this model, we prepared mouse glioma stem cells from a transgenic mouse model of GBM, based on INC4A loss and HRAS V12 activation. We performed repeated radiation to primary mouse glioma stem cells, MGS, in vitro. The radiation protocol consisted of 5 gray doses of radiation repeated every 3 or 4 days. The surviving cells were collected after 60 gray and called MGSRR. We evaluated in vivo radioresistance of 2 types of cells. Primary GSCs formed the tumor responded to radiation therapy and survival time was increased by 50%. But radioresistant squamous stem cells formed the tumor didn't respond and it has not survival benefit by radiation therapy. These data indicated that GSRR have a strong radioresistance. To analyze mechanism of therapeutic resistance, we compare the characteristics of 2 types of cells. We found that radioresistant glioma stem cells reduced cell proliferation and increased stemness. Stem cell marker oligo-2 gradually increased during repeated irradiation, but the neural differentiation marker TOG1 was decreased. We also found that radioresistant glioma stem cells form tightly packed spheres compared to control glioma stem cells, which indicating higher cell-cell adhesion. We examined the expression level of several cell-cell adhesion molecules and finally found that N-cadherin expression is dramatically increased during repeated irradiation. To analyze the role of N-cadherin, we established N-cad knockout glioma stem cells by CRISPR-Cas9. N-cad knockout cells cannot form tightly packed spheres and increase cell proliferation and decrease stemness. As shown before, GSR formed tumor didn't respond radiation therapy. However, mouse implanted with N-cad knockout radioresistant glioma stem cells display a survival benefit after whole brain irradiation. These data indicated that NCAD knockout gram stem cells lose their acquired phenotype. To clarify the underlying mechanism, we analyzed the binding pattern of NCAD and we found that NCAD traps beta-catenin at the cell surface, which suppresses beta-catenin nuclear translocation, resulting in reduced Wnt signaling. Immunofluorescence images show that beta-catenin co-accumulates at the cell surface with NCAD. Luciferase reporter assay indicates that radioresistant gram stem cells have a lower Wnt beta-catenin activity. Microarray analysis also shows that the expression of Wnt target genes are suppressed in radioresistant gram stem cells. To further unveil the downstream effectors of NCAD induced radioresistance, we performed RNA-seq analysis and identified anti-apoptosis protein Clusterin expression gradually increased during repeated irradiation. NCAD knockout suppressed Clusterin, while NCAD restoration increased Clusterin. NCAD directly regulates Clusterin expression. Mechanistically, NCAD-mediated Clusterin elevation regulates apoptosis. Clusterin knockdown increased cleaved PARP expression after radiation. The next question is how to target this NCAD-mediated radioresistance pathway. We analyzed the upstream pathway of NCAD hidden elevation and found that NCAD is upregulated by IGF-1-mediated EMT-like signaling. IGF-1 is upregulated in GSRR. IGF-1 treatment increases NCAD expression. IGF-1 inhibitors significantly suppress NCAD-mediated radioresistance in vitro. In the mouse model, combination therapy of radiation and IGF-1 receptor inhibitor PPP significantly increase mouse survival implanted with radioresistant gram stem cells. In conclusion, in gram stem cells, DNA damage induce IGF-1 secretion and activate EMT signaling, which elevate NCAD expression. NCAD accumulate beta-catenin on the cell surface and suppress beta-catenin nuclear translocation, resulting suppressed Wnt beta-catenin signaling, which induces slow growth and higher stemness. NCAD also increase Clusterin expression, inducing anti-apoptosis signaling. This NCAD mediated radioresistance pathway can be suppressed by IGF-1 receptor inhibitor. IGF-1 receptor inhibitor could be a new treatment strategy to inhibit radioresistance in glioblastoma.
So we reviewed the role of IGF-1 NCAD hidden Clusterin signaling axis for radioresistance in gram stem cells.
So in conclusion, our studies are important because they reveal a new pathway through which glioma cells can become resistant to radiation, and this has potential implications for treatment for patients, because we can now design new clinical trials to test how to exploit this knowledge to design new therapies. And I wish to also thank our collaborators who helped with this study and make this possible, as well as the funding agencies who provided the resources that enabled our studies. Thank you so much.